corresponding fixture. The new owners may well have been on song, so were Napoli, as they took a well-deserved lead. Cue a Roy of the Rovers performance in the second half from Steven Gerrard. His hat-trick, moving Liverpool 3 points clear at the top of the group. Roy Hodgson's side secured their place in the knockouts with a draw in Bucharest. Milan Jovanovic on the score sheet. Pepe Reina's rare slip meant a share of the spoils, though, but Liverpool safely through to the last 32. And that means that Liverpool have sealed top spot in Group K. The only issue left to resolve is whether Napoli or Steaua join the Reds in that knockout phase. The Italians, well, they have got to win to progress. OK, then, it's Football on Five. This is the only place to enjoy a live match tonight. Stan Collymore with me as always. Welcome, Stan.
Hi, Jim.
After a couple of mad Mondays since we last spoke, Messrs. Hughton and Allardyce both out of the door.
Well, it's crazy, isn't it? I mean, Chris Hughton has got Newcastle United into mid-table. Sam Allardyce was always going to do the same this season with Blackburn Rovers. Venky's at Blackburn Rovers and Mike Ashley at Newcastle may well know what they're doing in terms of their own individual businesses, but major question marks about them owning and administering football clubs. Crazy week.
The owners here seem to be taking a bit more of a long-term view.
Yeah, I mean, lots of Liverpool fans are split on Roy Hodgson. Many want him to leave, but I certainly don't think he's going to be gone before the end of the season. I think it'd be interesting to see, does he have a transfer budget in January and how he spends it? I think that's the question mark for most Liverpool fans.
Split on Roy Hodgson and a bit of a split personality with the team. Hodgson's away record, both with Fulham and with Liverpool, looks pretty poor.
Yeah, I was at St James's Park on Saturday evening to see them against Newcastle, and just a pale imitation of Liverpool sides that have played in years gone by. Very little creativity, and with the team line-up tonight, you'd hope that there are players playing for places, but an awful away record for Fulham and for Liverpool for Roy Hodgson.
Well, they're at home tonight, and this is the team. Brad Jones gets a starving goal, former Middlesbrough keeper. Skirtle, the skipper, on his 26th birthday. 18-year-old Shelvey in the midfield, and a new name up front. We'll talk more about him later on. He is 19. He's called Nathan Eccleston. Let's go down to Pat Nevin, who's been battling away with 4,000 or so Utrecht fans down there. Pat, you look nice and calm and peaceful. No problems then?
Well, sort of calm and peaceful. The Liverpool fans are slowly but surely coming in, and they will fill up this place in a little while. However, if you look behind me here, this lot have been in for about an hour, and there's 4,000 of them, and they're a wee bit quiet just now, but they've been very, very noisy, and they're going to add to the atmosphere, and I'm happy they're adding to a good atmosphere, because big players want to play in a good atmosphere. And Joe Cole, for me, is a player who's very important that he gets a good atmosphere to play in. He is really important to Liverpool's future. Creativity is what Liverpool have lacked. Stanley Mustin and I were chatting about this beforehand. If they haven't got a creativity, then players like Torres, etc., don't get enough chances and start to get a little bit disheartened. And the thing about Joe Cole, he is a player that is capable of doing that. And this is a good game for him, because it's a team that are tough to beat. Utrecht fans know they've been unlucky in this competition so far. They've had quite a lot of goals, a lot of draws in this competition so far. But they've played well, but they've not got through. Not affected this lot, but it could well be a good opportunity for Joe Cole to show his skills tonight. I certainly hope he does, because Liverpool needs him.
Thank you very much indeed, Pat. And Pat will be keeping a special eye on the creative process involving Joe Cole throughout the game. Couple of late surprises, though, in that Liverpool lineup. Let's find out about the selection process, shall we? Tony Jones is with the boss, Roy Hodgson.
Roy, many supporters who have seen the morning newspapers would have said, where's Fernando Torres tonight? It is a surprising lineup.
Yeah, I had a change of heart there, I must say. I apologise to those reporters. I was seriously considering giving Fernando a start. We thought it might be a nice game and hopefully a chance for him to, you know, get his confidence back and score a goal perhaps, you know, which would serve us in good stead. But of course I also had a talk to our fitness people, and you know, they made me see sense in the end that maybe it wasn't the wisest thing to do, because we are qualified. It would be taking the place of a young player who maybe deserves a chance to continue in the team or to stake a claim. And furthermore, of course, it would have been very bad for us if the worst had happened and he'd maybe picked up an injury which kept him out of the game. The same applies to Pepe Reina. It would have been a So in the end, I saw sense and listened to the reason all around me and changed my mind. But it doesn't affect the crowd. The 40,000 people who bought their tickets did that long before I said anything about the lineup. But I'm a bit sad that I've, tricked unintentionally a few journalists.
When you look at the lineup, obviously we know about Shelvey now and Kelly, but you've brought in Wilson and also Eccleston.
Yeah, well, both of them. I mean, Wilson played in Stour and did pretty well. And of course, one of the reasons for him getting in the team is we have injuries to Jamie Carragher and Daniel Agger. So we really are extremely short in the centre back area. We've only got the two that are playing, Sotos and Martin Skirtle, and they have to take some part in today's game. And as far as Nathan's concerned, he's now made two or three substitute appearances and done extremely well on each one. So if anyone deserves a chance, it's him. So I'm pleased in the end that I'm going in this game where we really have nothing to lose as such with some of these younger players. So I think it'll be exciting to see them.
And of course, with a final appearance last season with Fulham, what does this give to you at Liverpool this time around? Is it your best opportunity perhaps to win a trophy?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's certainly, if you look at our league position, it's certainly a little bit more likely we could win the Europa League than to win the Barclays Premiership at the moment. But of course, we're still in the FA Cup. I know we've got a tough draw against Manchester United, but we're still in the FA Cup, so we still hope for those two competitions. But it's been a long Europa year for me, which I'm really very, very pleased about. I'm really delighted that with all the injury problems we've had and the changes I've made in the team, that we've actually got through this group stage as winners, whatever the outcome of tonight's game. And I'm really looking forward to the draw on Friday to see who we're going to be pitted against.
Okay, well, he took a long time to make a decision. I don't think he'd lose too much sleep about upsetting a few journalists, but what a chance for the 19-year-old Eccleston, and you know a bit about him.
Yeah, I mean, he played his last 11 minutes against Steaua Bucharest. He's made five appearances, so this is his sixth and his first start. I think I'll be looking for him. He's got loads of pace. I'll be looking for him to run into the channels. But his all-round game tonight. Can he hold the ball up? Can he give opportunities for people like Joel Cole to play the ball up to him and be reliable? Looking forward to his performance.
And as a former striker and a very popular striker here at Anfield, you will keep a close eye on him for us, won't
Absolutely.
You?
Absolutely, him and Ryan Babel. They should be no more than 10, 15 yards apart. Hopefully they'll get plenty of ball and plenty of shots on target.
OK, Stan, thank you very much indeed. Well, less than half an hour to kick off. And when we return, well, we're going to be taking a pretty close look at just who Liverpool and indeed Manchester City might be facing in that knockout phase. Football on Five, the only place for live football tonight. Utrecht warming up, haven't won in the Europa League. They did knock Celtic out of Europe, though, earlier in the season. As for Manchester City, they continue their eventful season tomorrow evening in Turin, looking to secure top spot in Group A with a victory over Juventus. They, very much like Liverpool, already through to the knockout stages. So, as the group phase concludes, let's just take a look at who else is in the mix.
With 120 games played and a total of 342 goals scored so far, there's been no shortage of entertainment during the first five match days. In Group A, Manchester City and Lech Poznan are already safely through. City 2 points clear and favourites to top the group. The Blues may be in disarray about their captain's recent transfer request, but it's been Messi's Adebayor and Balotelli who have impressed so far in Europe. Bayer Leverkusen have already qualified from Group B as winners. They boast the best defence in the competition. Atletico Madrid and Aris Salonika are equal on points in second spot. Aris have the better head-to-head record, so they just have to equal the reigning champions result to qualify. In Group C, Sporting have impressed on the way to clinching top spot. Lille and Ghent battle it out in France tomorrow to reach the last 32. Ghent hold a 2-point advantage, so a draw will be enough. Villarreal are safely through from a tightly fought Group D. PAOK Salonika and Dinamo Zagreb are head-to-head tonight to join them in the knockout stages. PAOK hold a 1-point advantage, but have to travel to Croatia. Either could finish as group winners. Dinamo Kiev and Bate Borisov have strolled into the last 32 from Group E, both currently on 10 points. Dinamo's Roman Eremenko has the most assists in the competition, and the two sides' respective results tonight will decide who wins the group. Group F is already decided, CSKA Moscow secured top spot with 5 wins out of 5. They're the competition's top scorers with 17 goals and will certainly be a team to avoid. Sparta Prague also qualified as runners-up. Like their Russian counterparts in Moscow, Zenit St. Petersburg have already wrapped up Group G, 5 wins out of 5 and averaging 3 goals a game. AK Athens in second place need just a point from their last fixture to qualify. Anderlecht, 3 points in arrears, must win and hope that other results go their way. In Group H, 2 teams already have their feet up. Despite struggling in the Bundesliga, Stuttgart finished top of the group. Young boys in the competition following their Champions League qualifying defeat to Spurs have taken the runners-up spot. Eredivisie leaders and one of the competition's front-runners, PSV Eindhoven, have qualified from Group I. Medalist Kharkiv can still just about pip them to top spot though. Tomorrow night in the Netherlands, they'll need to match or better the 2-0 margin when the two sides met earlier in the competition. In Group J, Paris Saint-Germain have already successfully qualified, but the group winner is still to be decided. Bundesliga leaders Borussia Dortmund travel to Sevilla on matchday 6, 1 point behind the second place Spanish team, who need just a draw to progress. With a little bit of help along the way, Besiktas joined Porto in the knockout stages from Group L. Porto's flamboyant striker Falcao is the competition's leading scorer, and the Portuguese league leaders will be a tough match for any side when they take their place in the draw for the last 32.
So then, this is how it looks so far. Liverpool through as group winners, 4 Champions League seeds are coming through as well. Ajax 20, Braga and Spartak Moscow. 6 places still to be sorted out. And looking at that, it means there is a possibility of Liverpool against Glasgow Rangers. Stan Collymore, your reaction?
Yeah, with the players out, and once you reconvene come February time, there have been lots of games played over the winter, and purely from a selfish perspective, you'd want to play a game where you can get up. That would be Rangers-Liverpool, without a doubt, just up the road. National bragging rights, 2 full houses. The game that you'd want to avoid, or games, would be like Rubin Kazan, Metalist Kharkiv, anywhere that's a 5 or 6 hour flight.
Absolutely, and just a reminder that that draw takes place on Friday. Terrific initiative here by Liverpool under the Shankly statue. They're allowing 4 kids in free, providing them with an adult paying just £20. It'll mean a full house here at Anfield, and well done Liverpool FC on that. They're all having a great time. It is Football on 5 Live from Anfield. Less than 15 minutes to go to the kick-off, but now it is competition time. We're giving you the chance to win a pair of VIP tickets to see the Premier League team of your choice in action, the football shirt of your choice, a 42-inch LCD TV, plus an Apple iPad and a football shirt. All you've got to do is text FOOTBALL to 6550 or post your name and phone number to Europa 6 P.O. Box 46556, London N10WW. Text costs £1 plus one message at standard network rate. The lines close midday tomorrow. 3 days later for postal entries. We'll contact the winner and announce their name on 5.tv. And the best of luck to you all. Let us go back down to Pat Nevin pitchside now. And Pat, you want to talk about Liverpool's centre-halves tonight, don't you?
Well, absolutely, because Danny Wilson's a young player that back up in Scotland, he's playing with Rangers, we're all very, very impressed with. This is only 3rd game for Liverpool. He's actually scored for Scotland in his international debut as well. But he's a classy player, and centre-backs usually take quite a long time to cook, you know. Usually need a little bit of experience behind them, and this will be great experience for that young lad tonight. I think he's a fantastic player, or a fantastic player of the future. When he's talked about in Scotland, there's only one name that's usually mentioned alongside his, and it's Alan Hansen, and that's not bad to hear around these parts. So a very, very good player that is going to learn a lot, and he's against a decent team tonight. I think Utrecht are a decent side, and he will get tested tonight because they're decent going forward. But at least he got a little bit of help as well, a bit alongside him with Martin Skirtle. He needs a bit of experience beside him, you know, just to tell him where to go. He worked with David Weir up at Rangers, and he learned a lot out of him. And there are good centre-backs at Liverpool just now. But you have to admit, Jamie Carragher, he ain't going to last forever. So eventually someone's going to have to take his place. And the young man, Danny Wilson, more likely than anyone else, is the man who's going to do that job.
Cheers, Pat. Thank you very much indeed. Skirtle, the skipper, on his 26th birthday tonight. Let's welcome John Scales, former Liverpool defender. He'll be alongside commentator Dave Woods tonight. John, great to have you with us.
Evening.
The best Liverpool pairing at the moment. Give us it. Centre-half pairing.
Yeah, I mean, Jamie Carragher's a big loss for Liverpool at the moment. You know, that leadership, the amount of games that he's played, the heartbeat of Liverpool along with Steven Gerrard. So it's important that he comes back from injury. But in the absence of him, Martin Skrtel's got an important job to do. Danny Wilson comes in, as we've just been hearing from Pat. They've got to form, you know, an understanding. Danny Wilson played alongside Kyriakos out in Stoya in the last round, in the last game. So he acquitted himself very well. But, you know, there's a lot of inexperience in that back four. And I think it's Skrtel who's really got to bring Danny Wilson, Kelly, Brad Jones in goal behind him. He's got to be the one. He's imposing, 6'4". And, you know, hopefully he will lead this this back four through a comfortable evening.
Scalo, vitally important tonight that not only Martin Skrtel, but Fabio Aurelio as well brings along young Danny Wilson, Martin Kelly, and, of course, a rookie goalkeeper in Brad Jones behind them as well. Give us an idea what kind of things Martin Skrtel might well be saying to Danny Wilson during the game.
I think what he'd be saying is just, you know, do the simple things well. Don't try and overcomplicate the game. Yes, he's got a bright future ahead of him, but these games, when you're settling into life at Anfield, keep the things simple. Do the good things really well and, you know, make good clearances. And I think it's just about settling in early, getting a good understanding, communicating well. I think, you know, centre-halves have got to communicate well with all around them. Brad Jones is important behind. He's got to be dominant. He's got to be clear with his instructions. And that breeds confidence in the back four. So, yeah, it's an important evening in the next stage of his development. But Skrtel will be the key man for me at the back there, obviously.
John, thank you very much indeed. Enjoy your commentary. One fellow we want to look at, a Van who has come out of Holland. As good as Van Nistelrooy?
Rocky and Bullwinkle. Sorry, I meant Ricky Van Wolfswinkle. Forgive the pun there. Only 21 years of age, and by all accounts, we're chatting to one or two people that Liverpool have sort of tracked his progress. You just see he's actually a converted attacking midfielder. Ball whipped in, just attacks the near post, little touch, goal. Takes penalties and free kicks as well. Drops this one down to the goalkeeper's right hand. And he scored 19 goals in 31 games, I think 11 in the Eredivisie this season. One to watch, and without a doubt, their talisman tonight.
OK, thank you, Stan. Nearly 4,000 fans are here from Utrecht, hoping to see their former star player, Dirk Kuyt. Dancing shoes at the ready for Liverpool and Utrecht. If you're just joining us, you're very welcome. Football on Five, the only station with live action tonight. Let's say a very good evening to your match commentator, Dave Woods.
Hi, Jim. Well, they do say Christmas is for the kids, and that's certainly how it feels at Anfield tonight. A fair sprinkling of fresh faces in amongst the Liverpool side taking to the pitch here. 18-year-old John Joe Shelby, 19-year-old Nathan Eccleston, 18-year-old Danny Wilson, and 8,500 under-17s are in here as well for free as an early Christmas gift from the club's new owners. So 10 changes to the Liverpool side that lost to Newcastle at the weekend. Martin Skrtel, the sole survivor, and he takes the armband for the first time on his birthday. Clutch of youngsters, Nathan Eccleston making his first Anfield start. Utrecht are playing for pride only tonight, but theirs is a starting 11 that is close to full strength. It's a lineup that includes a man we've already heard about, Ricky van Wolfswinkel, 21 years of age, 19 goals already this season. He's a man to watch. And he's the man who will lead their line as well, with the Irishman Maguire just behind in close support. Liverpool have done all the hard work, so tonight they can relax and put on a festive show. Liverpool against Utrecht is only moments away.
It's Football on Five. We are live from Anfield, putting on a show. Has to be the Reds' ambition tonight. John Scales, former Reds defender, is alongside match commentator Dave Woods.
Well, there'll be no dead games at Anfield while I'm in charge, was Roy Hodgson's command yesterday. He's expecting this team to win, and win well here. Relax at your peril, they have been told. And I tell you, it certainly doesn't feel like a European dead rubber here tonight. There's a terrific atmosphere inside Anfield, helped in to a great extent by the Utrecht fans who are here, making it feel like a real occasion, and a real occasion too for quite a few of these Liverpool players hoping to make their mark, including the man chasing this, if he can be called a man at 19 years of age, Nathan Eccleston, making his first Anfield start tonight. One of three teenagers running through the spine of this Liverpool side. There's some experience on the bench. There's a lot of experience sitting in the stands here tonight. And remember, Liverpool are already through, and are already going through as winners of Group K because of what they've done before. And Utrecht cannot progress. So it is a chance for both to relax and put on a show, as Jim was saying here, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Utrecht are going to, nothing to lose. They'll want to go out on a high, obviously. The pressure's off them in so many ways. Liverpool, it's a chance for these youngsters to really stake a claim. And that's what it's really about at the moment with Liverpool. It's a squad of players that's bereft of depth in quality. And so, you know, there's been a lot of acquisitions of young talent coming in here, and it's on display tonight. So a good chance for them to impress Roy Hodgson.
And we're in a play by the man who's captaining the side tonight, Martin Skrtel, on the occasion of his 26th birthday. The first time he's pulled on the Liverpool armband, of course. And very much a man that Liverpool will be looking towards to provide a senior role here. Not too many have got great experience, though they have a decent bench tonight, the likes of Johnson and Kyriakos and Torres and Kout, who was desperate to play, we were told, against one of his former teams. The manager deciding against that.
There's been a lot of speculation, hasn't there, what this starting lineup was going to be. Was Rainey going to be in goal? Was Torres going to try and play, you know, play back into some form, get a goal? And of course, Dirk Kuyt against his former team.
Skrtel. So Brad Jones, a rare touch for him. He's not exactly a youngster, Brad Jones, at 28, but I haven't seen too much of him in first-team football. Oh, and that's a mistake, but Skrtel is looking to try and wrap up. Wolfs Finkel dashing in, but Liverpool just about getting away with it.
Yeah, and they're the mistakes you don't really want to do in the first 5 minutes of a game. The last thing you need is Kelly putting his Skrtel, his partner, defensive partner, under pressure there with a poor back pass. And they recovered well, actually. Skrtel recovered very well. Wilson was sort of covering him nicely, but certainly not the start that Liverpool would have wanted with those little mishaps.
Here's Mertens. Sander Keller. Lisa. To Sander Keller again. Not having the best of times this season, Utrecht. They find themselves very much mid-table in Eredivisie. 8th place at the moment, 12 points behind the leaders, PSV. It's a very scrappy record they've had of late. They have only won at 1-1 in their last 5 games. So they're not actually marching here with any great confidence. But almost a night off, almost a chance to relieve any pressure that might have been growing for them in recent weeks and try to express themselves if they can. So swiftly put out of play. Tom du Chatinier is the Utrecht coach, very much a man of Utrecht, born in that city, played 10 years as a player there, and Skrtel was a youth coach and assistant manager, so he has nailed his colours to the Utrecht mast over the years. They're here to enjoy themselves tonight. Never Walk Alone anthem before, traditionally sung here, and every single Utrecht fan lifted their scarves and flags high as well. But when the draw was made, they highlighted the two games against Liverpool as a real glorious adventure for a club that is relatively new to football. Nearly 40 years of age. There's a few there that are a little older than 40 years of age. Still remain legends in these parts.
Yeah, we talk about the youngsters here tonight. You know, it's also important for the likes of Ryan Babel, you know, considered sort of a senior player here, but Ryan Babel sort of playing himself back into a little bit of form. Paulson, who you know, some would say has been disappointing since his move from Juventus, it's a big night for him. So it's also those sort of more senior players. Roy Hodgson's looking for them to really lead the youngsters through this time.
There's Keller, 31 years of age, very much an old man on the pitch tonight. Mertens, the run has been made by Dries Mertens, has failed to gather it in to continue, but has the beating of Kelly, and it needed Shelby to come back to rescue the situation.
Yeah, well, Kelly just needs to be helped out by Martin Skirtle. He's playing over on that right-hand side of the two central defenders, and just that long ball just caught him out. Luckily, the first touch was poor, and they got back to defend it nicely, Jonjo Shelby.
So nice challenge, but has left Nesu rather rolling on the floor in discomfort here. The referee has allowed the advantage, but it's going to be put out of play so that he can be treated here. And a yellow card for Nathan Eccleston.
Yeah, it's a poor time challenge. You know, it's very late. Maybe he's just the nerves are just in there. We've seen a little bit from Kelly at right back. Just a little bit of inexperience there from Eccleston. Over enthusiastic. And late challenge, and no surprise that the referees put him in his book.
What's Joe Curl going to do with this? Give it back, presumably. Mountains. This is Keller. Cornelisa. Little run made here by Mertens, and a nice touch from him too to the recovered Nesu, and Mertens is on his way again. So really proving a difficult night for Martin Kelly down this right hand side.
Well, Mertens has looked quite lively, hasn't he? He's got a good touch, looks quick, gets the ball out of his feet very quickly. So just in this opening 7 minutes or so, just causing him one or two problems and will make him slightly nervous.
Fabio Aurelio. It's Joe Curl playing on that left-hand side. Jovanovic on the right-hand side of midfield, unusually for Liverpool tonight. Towards Babel. Olsen's header. There is Jovanovic. Little channel for him to run into, and he has a look. Oh my lord! He did more than just have a look. That's a terrific effort.
Well, what a great strike from Jovanovic. I mean, he gets the ball, he has a couple of good touches, gets it out of his feet, and it opens up for him. And I wasn't sure whether the goalkeeper got a touch to it or not, but great strike from probably 30 yards out there. I think he's just got a fingertips to
it.
Great save.
Just the briefest of touches from the goalkeeper, Michael Vorm, Michel Vorm, I should say, his first choice goalkeeper. He wasn't due to be playing here tonight, Michel Vorm. He was going to have the night off, but Khalid Sinou, the Moroccan who would have taken his place, injured his hamstring in the training on the pitch last night. So Michel Vorm has had to come into the side, and Eric Cummings, who's the third choice goalkeeper, had to jump on a supporters coach and arrived here earlier today.
Now, Jovanovic, you know, he's got a good scoring record. You know, when he was at Standard Liège, I think it was 70 goals in 150-odd games. You know, he's taken some time to settle in here at Liverpool, but he's a player of talent, yet to show it in abundance, but we saw a glimpse of it there, certainly.
Switched away by Wilson. And here's Brad Jones. It's only his second appearance as well for Liverpool this season since his signing from Middlesbrough.
I didn't realise he was so long at Middlesbrough. What was it, 9 years
or
so?
9 years, but not many games. 75 games, which, you know, over 10 years now, less than 80 games played. It's a frustrating time for a number two goalkeeper, isn't it?
Yeah, I think he got a chance really when Mark Schwartz had moved on to Fulham, didn't he, and came in a little bit, but that's not many games, so he's got a great chance here this evening.
That's Babel, not control. Mertens. Look up, but can't pick the pass, so Paulson with the interception. And here's Shelby. This is Kelly looking to push. Jovanovic. Still has the support of Kelly if needed. Back to Paulson. Kelly. By Nessa. Throw in to Utrecht. Not the greatest of pedigrees, have they? They were formed as a result of an amalgamation of three clubs back in 1970, Utrecht. Since then they've been in and out of Europe, mostly out. Won the Dutch Cup on a number of occasions, three times. The last of those was 6 years ago. Their mark on Europe this year either. Here's Cornelissa. Nessu. They're happy to keep possession inside their own half here, but not too adventurous at the moment.
Yeah, Liverpool are just happy, aren't they, to allow them to have the ball at the back there. They're not going to go and press high up the pitch. That's not Roy Hodgson's way particularly. And Liverpool at the moment just comfortable, the two centre-halves playing it around at the back there. But, you know, certainly there's been, you know, one or two encouraging signs at the start here that, you know, Eccleston, I think, just played it simple, got the ball up, popped it off to a teammate. Ryan Babel, you know, another important game for him tonight. As I said before, you know, he's played his way into a little bit of form recently. Good for him to get the chance and have some confidence from the manager. That's what I feel Ryan Babel needs, is really to feel that the manager has great faith in him, and he's shown that in some recent performances.
The risk there of the Utrecht back four boring us to death, but it has gone out of play for a Liverpool throw, thankfully. There's a man who really wanted to play here, as we mentioned earlier, Dirk Kuyt, against the side he was with for 5 years. Years ago, Cole, it's Marble. Liverpool looking for a little bit of purchase, but finding none, and untidily giving away the throw.
Yeah, a bit over elaborate down that side, wasn't it? But Dirk Kuyt, yeah, I mean, you know, made his name, scored a lot of goals for Utrecht, went on to Feyenoord, and you know, then has been an integral part of this Liverpool team, and. You know, it was his team, Holland, that knocked out Martin Skrtel's Slovakia in the World Cup, in the knockout stage of the World Cup this summer. Martin Skrtel playing all of his Slovakian team's games.
There's Nessu, being a little more adventurous for Utrecht. Skrtel's claiming the last touch came off the Dutchman, and he has been given his way. Certain terms sending his message out there, Roy Hodgson.
He's certainly become more and more animated on the sidelines as the season's progressed. Now he's certainly feeling the pressure.
Struggling to get their rhythm at the moment.
Yeah.
Head up.
It's always going to be difficult when you've got so many new faces in the team. You know, it's in some ways it's similar to the Stoyer lineup. You know, playing 4-4-2, the youngsters coming into the side. But you know, they really have got to settle down, and those early nerves, overcome those, get some pattern of play, get the passes, movement, all sorted out in the game, and they can settle down.
Well, if you are just joining us with a little over 40 minutes played, you haven't missed too much so far. A thunderbolt of a shot from Milan Jovanovic, which crashed against the Utrecht crossbar. From that, we haven't seen too much from the Utrecht back four. It's keen and content to keep the ball whenever they have it. Martin Kelly's had a experience in Europe this year. This is the ninth European tie he's played it. Started quite a few of those as well. Seen him being used as a makeshift left back at times as well.
You know, for me tonight, this is a night for bringing Joe Cole into the game as often as possible. You know, Joe's out there on the left-hand side of midfield, you know, playing his way back into form and fitness. You know, I think Liverpool have got to search out that option to bring him into the game as much as they can. Don't want to leave him as a sort of peripheral figure. Again, in that story game, noticed, you know, coming back from injury, one or two poor touches. It's important, I think, this game tonight that he has that chance to get a lot of touches of the ball.
Here's Keller. He's certainly had a lot of touches of the ball so far this evening. Here's Silverbauer. Forcing the pass and giving Liverpool possession, and a chance now maybe for them to build something here through Babel. Jovanovic back to Babel. Little poke by here, the back heel by Cole. Anticipating the run, but he couldn't make it because he had been fouled. So the free kick in a very interesting position here.
Yeah, I think it was Nezu, was it, that sort of tracked him, had the first challenge, and then they just fell over the ball and had the collision, so it wasn't Nezu, but it was a free kick nevertheless, and gives Liverpool another opportunity to have a strike on goal and test the keeper.
Well, left foot of Aurelio, or is 18-year-old John Joe Shelby going to have a go from here? A little discussion between the two to consider their options.
Yeah, Aurelio definitely fancies this one, doesn't he? You just see his...
It is Aurelio who tries to chip it in, but headed away by a wall that did its job. Finkel, little header on, and Maguire's after it here. Quite falling for him. And Skirtle again can clear with relative ease. Here's Aurelio. And last off Sander Keller, so a Liverpool throw in here. Midway inside this Utrecht half.
We saw a glimpse there of Torres, didn't we, on the bench. You know, and they've got... he's got the options, obviously, on the sidelines. Cow definitely will play some part in this game. I think we can rest assured of that. Whether Torres will or not, I doubt it. I think Roy Hodgson made the right decision in resting Reina and Torres with the games coming up. I mean, they've got Fulham at the weekend, they've got Blackpool away, and I think then they've got Wolves and Bolton at home as well. So they've got some home games coming up as well. Their home form's been great, just their away form has been so dire. And again, we've seen that in the Europa League with the three away draws, so far, and the two wins at home.
The last five home games have resulted in victory for Liverpool. And they haven't conceded many in that time, have they? It's Cornelisa. A couple to aim for in the middle, but he's not going to find them with a ball like that. And Jovanovic looking to ease it to safety, and gets a knee in his back for his pains.
Yeah, it's a good run of fixtures for Liverpool coming up over Christmas. You know, starts here, you know, if they can get a good win here, finish convincingly in the group.
Well, a chance here for Eccleston, maybe. He's having force wide. Jovanovic and Babel in the middle. It's Cole who's back in support here. Little movement made by Babel, the flick attempted, but not successful.
Yeah, Joe Cole trying to whip it in with real pace. The run to the near post makes it awkward for Babel to control the ball in that situation. Wasn't sure. I think he was going for sort of the far post. Knocked in with pace.
At the start of the season, you would have looked at the run of Liverpool's next four games and said, win, 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 win. Fulham at home, Blackpool away, as you said, Wolves at home and Bolton at home. But it's a strange old season in the Premier League, isn't it?
Yeah, it is very strange. I mean, it's so congested, isn't it? You know, a run of good form takes you right up there. Lack of results, you know, suddenly you find yourself down in the bottom half of the table and struggling again and under pressure. And it's been the story for all the teams this year.
Here's Maguire laying a nice ball off for Van Wolfswinkel. He's looking for the gap to thread it through, but closed down eagerly enough by Danny Wilson. Liverpool not out of trouble yet, though. Here's Cornelissa. Nicely led by Mertens. Whipped in by Van Wolfswinkel, but too close to Brad Jones. Comfortable catch for the Australian.
Yeah, Danny Wilson did well though, tracked the runner, could have dived in, looked like he wanted to get a foot in there, realised that it broke into the box and just stood off him, held his feet, stayed on his feet and just averted the danger with a good blocking tackle.
Paulson. Here's Wilson. Another Dane, Christian Paulsen again. Eccleston ahead, making little darts hither and thither, wanting an early ball. Skirtle. Liverpool's turn to rather dominate possession here inside their own half. It's Aurelio. Shelby. Gliding past the defenders here, John Joe Shelby, and still providing a real menace. In the end, Edward Duplan had to come in and rescue his defenders, but has lost it again. Aurelio swinging it over, and Bartons puts it up for a corner kick. But excellent play by John Joe Shelby there.
Yeah, he was. Shows what a good prospect he is. He's highly rated here. Good feet, good awareness around him. Good result for Liverpool getting the corner, to be honest, there, because there was nobody really in the box going to threaten the goal. The ball was crossed in, but everybody was sort of out on that left-hand side, and there's a relief that they got the corner, and here's a chance for Liverpool.
Here comes Shelby to deliver. It's a decent one as well. Climbing high was Danny Wilson. Unable to connect in the manner he intended.
Yeah, we were talking before, weren't we, in the build-up to the game, you know, about the centre-half partnerships, and, you know, you look around the rest of the league. One thing I suppose that's, you know, as much as it's important to get the right partnership defensively, it's also at set pieces. None of the centre halves, Skirtle, Kyriakos, Carragher, Agger once or twice, but don't really pose a goal threat going forward either at those set pieces. Danny Wilson had a chance there, but just got sort of caught underneath the ball.
Daniel Agger tends to score the unconventional goals in the opponent's penalty area, doesn't he? Not the towering headers, but the flicks and the back heels. And the clever stuff every now and again. Here comes Eccleston. Pretty solid route.
Well, he got that great goal against West Ham, wasn't it, a few years ago? Great strike. I think that got Liverpool's goal of the season.
Scored against Lisbon as well, I think, last year, didn't he?
Yeah, I think
memory
he did.
Serves, Sporting Lisbon.
Yeah, Skirtle's played 100-odd games, 101 games, I think it is now, since he moved 3 years ago, coming up in January, I think. So, you know, only a couple of goals, Man City and Spurs, actually, just recently.
Free kick here for Liverpool. It's been a lively game so far, despite the fact that it's been billed as a dead rubber. A game in which both sides know their fate, whatever happens here, but they've given us decent fare thus far. Aurelio with a ball in, over the head of Bubble. Headed away by Keller. Here's Paulson. Aurelio. Bubble with good movement again. Carrying it. And just getting the deflection on the ball, otherwise it would have tested the Utrecht defence. As it is, it's going to be a corner kick.
Yeah, just again, you know, that Liverpool, you know, with Jovanovic playing on the right-hand side here, he's going to cut him in his left. Joe Cole's going to cut it on his right. The ball's going to be whipped in. More often than not, you get the feeling it's going to come into that back area. And once or twice there, I've just seen Jovanovic get dragged in too far into the near side of the goal instead of just hanging back on that back post.
So here comes Aurelio to try and deliver here. Headed away safely enough by Vaughans. Jovanovic. Kelly. Here's Paulson. They're looking for the muscular movement and doing well. It just across it, hadn't it? Had stayed in, but looked up by Michel Vorm. In fact, it had gone out of play. It's a goal kick.
Yeah, it was always going to be difficult to wrap his foot around that at such an acute angle. But he did well getting the touch out of his feet, showing a little bit of strength and just trying to whip that ball in.
Vaughans to his goalkeeper Vorm. The two Liverpool players closing in, but easily done by the goalkeeper. This is Martin Skrtel. Cautious here as they build again from inside their own half. Rather less than cautious, using Skrtel's ball forward. And we've got one Liverpool ex-player up with us on the gantry here in the shape of John Scales. We've got another one watching from closer to the edge of the pitch. Stan Collymore, what are your thoughts so far?
Yeah, I'm just looking at Joe Cole's game, Dave, and he's stuck out over on that left-hand side and he's trying desperately to get involved in the game, but he's not a wide left or wide right midfielder, to be perfectly honest. Joe Cole is best playing in between the opposition midfield and back four, turning very quickly and being able to spot the runs of the two strikers. So it's obviously a position Roy Hodgson is playing him in tonight, but for me, Joe Cole is well lost over on that left-hand side.
Vaughans. And a familiar pattern again here, Vaughans to Keller, but this time Keller goes forward, much more direct this time. Silverbar is the man on the chase, but he's never going to get there.
No, Stan's absolutely right. You know, I said before, Joe, you know, needs to be brought into the game. When he's out there, he's got to be brought in. The Liverpool players have got to find him. They're not doing that so often. There's got to be the movement around him, but you know, he needs to be involved in games. He needs to be constantly, you know, having the touches, having the flicks, having the movement. And you know, if he's a peripheral figure out there, he'll get wasted as that talent.
Away by Keller. Here's Mertens. Chosen by Nesu here. Jovanovic looking to close him down. Duplan. And Lisa. Liverpool's pressing, forcing Utrecht temporarily back inside their own half. Here's Cornelissa again. It's the Belgian Jan Vaughans. There's a looker around him, can't find a way forward, so it goes all the way back to Michel Vorm.
It's very much the way the Liverpool team have evolved over the last couple of months. You know, Roy Hodgson seems to prefer this sort of 4-4-2. Now it was more inventive at times, 4-4-1-1 at times, with Joe Cole just behind when they first came to the club. You know, now it's very much, I suppose, in the last 3 or 4 weeks, going with the two up front, trying to have a partner alongside Torres, playing Babel. Eccleston having the chance this afternoon, and Gogg coming into the team and doing relatively well. But that does mean, I think, with the midfield players they've got, that they don't have the creativity from midfield really to sort of break up that four in midfield pattern and bring in the likes of Joe Cole and utilise those skills and the qualities that he's really got.
Here's Vaughans and Keller. I'm going to get sick of saying those two players' names as the night goes on. They've had more of the possession than any other players on the pitch so far. Duplan. Inevitably it comes back to the central defensive pairing.
Mertens, long and hopeful, but Skirtle to intercept. Kelly. And Riddle has one challenge, but fouled on his way, so a free kick here for Liverpool. We're nearly half an hour played.
Well, he would be glad of the foul there. Just looked like for a minute he was going to play himself into a little bit of trouble. Kelly, he's had a bit of a nervous start to this game. He's been very impressive, actually, when what we've seen of him this season, fleetingly. But half an hour gone, and no real rhythm to the game, is there? Just Liverpool can't find a sort of pattern of play that's breaking down Utrecht. Utrecht playing deep, playing organised. But it'll be frustrating. Liverpool want to get this breakthrough soon, just to settle those nerves and be able to sort of dictate play much more at a home game.
Ripple of applause for the adventure shown there by Liverpool. Aurelio had made the run, and also for Torres, who's off the bench for a little bit of a warm-up. I don't think it means his arrival is imminent. It's just a case of keeping warm on what is a chilly night here at Anfield. There's Barbel. Shelby. Skirtle. Touch and turn by Aurelio. Looking to dink it in. Marble will challenge. Shelby. What about hitting it first time on the left foot? Went for the more cultured approach on the right. Eccleston. And now Martin Kelly. Shelby losing out. Utrecht with a chance to break. Barry Maguire. Oh dear. Denise Mertens giving up on that very early in the piece. And Antoine du Châtinier, the Utrecht coach, is far from happy.
No, may well he be, because they had a chance to break forward there, and it was a pretty sloppy pass on a very slick pitch here at Anfield.
Marble looking to work himself into position here. Aurelio, a bit of a drive from him, and skipped over by Favre to give himself an extra opportunity in the angle here. Blocked away towards Mertens. Nessa.
That was a demonstration, I think, of how Liverpool can break through here. You know, Joe Cole came deep, dragged the full-back in tight with him. And it's Babel making the run in the channel, as Eccleston has done, you know, in this first half. So I think there's been good movement from Babel and Eccleston. Very impressed with both their effort and movement. And, you know, if they can be drawn out of position, the two centre-halves can be dragged out wide in dangerous areas.
Here comes Kelly again, looking for the widest route on the field, past the defenders. And again, the defence has given it away. So Jovanovic stuttering and moving in. Poulsen. Poor ball by him. Eccleston does well to keep it in play, though, and keep Liverpool's attacking intentions alive here. Here's Cole. And again. Poulsen. Nice touch by him. Kelly. Not able to continue with Liverpool's move. Frustrating for the side in red just at the moment, as Duplan brings it away.
Well, it's Poulsen a couple of times there, you know, a man who's been criticised on the terraces here at times, but you know, a couple of instances there of sloppy play from Poulsen as well. Had possession, given it away, and you know, that'll begin to frustrate the home crowd again. He has been a target. Don't like to see that, but you know, you do expect a little bit better from Poulsen there, an experienced player in the middle of midfield.
Here's Foutens. Picking up Dries Mertens, the Belgian on his left-hand flank. silver bar of the day. It's Duplan who's going to Cornelissa, who's picked a position on that right-hand side. Wilson's header away. Niholt's happy to see it out of play for a throw-in for his side.
It was a good passage of play beforehand, wasn't there, with Joe Cole, you know, coming into the centre midfield almost, you know, picked up the ball, had a little give and go, you know, and if you can get that movement and if you can get involved in that that central area, we got a glimpse there of Liverpool just sort of having a bit of a spark about them, that if Joe is left out there, they haven't really got it with Shelvey and Paulson in the middle of the field there.
Skirtle's header met by Niholt, and Skirtle returns the favour. It's a big thump downfield, and Keller immediately looking for a long ball here to test that Liverpool line. Kelly heads away, but again sloppily given away by Paulson. Niholt, here's Nesu. Mertens. Drag it out of play. Well, Liverpool needlessly putting themselves under pressure here.
They were. Yeah, it was a bit of a slip up.
McGuire with the ball in. Shelby with a header away. Quickly taken throw. They want to get on with it here. Mertens lifting it high. Jones has an eye on it but doesn't get a fist on it. And he needed Joe Cole in there to make sure it was clear from danger.
A little bit unconvincing, didn't read it too well, realised then that he was going to get in trouble just trying to get over the top of the Utrecht player, and you need, you know, a keeper to really come and come through everything strongly, forcefully and punch, you know, well clear, and that just dropped down into a danger area but luckily cleared for Liverpool.
There's Fountains. Shelby winning it back for his team, Cole. And Fabio Aurelio. Liverpool's fans urging their players to attack here. Scuttle's a big clear away. It's goalless in the other match in this group, by the way. Napoli against Stoke. That means if it stays that way, Steaua Bucharest would be going through in second place in Group K. Napoli have to win that match to qualify for the knockout stages from February onwards.
Yeah, it's an intriguing tie, that one, isn't it? Napoli, you know, in good form in Serie A. And, you know, that really, for me, was the catalyst for Liverpool that I thought was going to be a revival, really, in their fortunes, the Napoli game, when Steven Gerrard came off the bench and got that second-half hat-trick. That was a great night here, and put Liverpool 3 points clear in this group, and really, for me, cemented their place in the next round.
Well played there by Eccleston, trying to produce that spark for Liverpool. Mertens. Here's Maguire, too much to do. Skirtle and Jones, short-footed, clears away. Nesu. There's Van Wolfsfinkel. Maguire. Overrun by Cole. Liverpool with a chance to launch something here. Barbol, he's got plenty of work to do. And nice defending by Silberbauer. Not only in winning the ball, but in winning the free kick as well.
Yeah, took it cleanly. Did very, very well tracking back. I thought Babel might just get away and get a run on the back four.
This is Keller.
Utrecht really haven't posed much of a threat, you know, at all. Van Wolfsinkel, I was hoping, you know, looking forward to seeing him play, seeing a little bit of movement, but, you know, no real penetration from them from midfield. Just the one or two, you know, just down this right-hand side, I suppose, Martin Kelly a couple of times put his Martin Skirtle in trouble in that early stages, but they've settled down as a back four, really, because they haven't asked too many questions of them.
You know what's going to happen now, don't you? Wolfsinkel goal in the next 2 minutes after you set that. Your commentator's that? Curse.
It'll be my curse, yeah. Hopefully not, but it, you know, it does look like if Liverpool are to be undone this evening, it will be of their own doing.
And just a hint here, here he comes, Van Wolfswinkel. This is Duplan. Silver bar. It's Mertens who is the intended target, but not a good enough ball to reach him. Chilly dog and a chilly night. Nessu's throw. There's Cornelisa. This is Duplan. Barry Maguire. He is Dutch, by the way, Barry Maguire. He's got Irish heritage, hence the name. There's every chance he could be playing for Ireland in the future as well. He is a Dutch youth international. He's done this from Ireland, and that's what he said his intentions may lie in the future.
All those youngsters who have been let in tonight for free, great gesture by the club, haven't really had too much to shout about. Bit of a flat atmosphere, and you know, that's where you need the players to step up and put a little bit more energy, maybe push up the pitch a bit higher. I think that's what they're encouraging them to do. Eccleston there closing down, but it's got to come from midfield and from the back. Don't play deep, push up. We just heard the crowd, you know, starting to call out for attack, attack, attack. And they really want to see a bit more impetus here in the team as the ball's kicked out for an injury.
Well, we're going to have another delay here because Ricky van Wolfswinkel, the man of the moment, is down with an injury. It was John Joe Shelby's challenge, was it? No, it was a challenge, in fact, from Danny Wilson. That's a very awkward fall.
Yeah, the striker
required.
Similar to what Jamie Carragher got at Spurs with a dislocated shoulder, you know, just a few weeks ago. But he looks in quite a lot of pain. It was just a very, very heavy fall on that shoulder, on the neck. Looks in a lot of pain and doubtful whether he'll be able to continue. But going back, Jamie Carragher, you know, big loss at the centre-half. You know, I thought Skirtle's done okay actually this evening. Big job really to bring Danny Wilson through. So much thought of Danny Wilson and so much expectation. Still very early days in his career, as it is with Martin Kelly. John Joe Shelby, I thought, done very well in midfield this evening. But it's those senior players who've got to step up. They've really got to dictate the play here. That's what you've got to look from your senior players.
Well, there was nothing in the challenge, was there? It was just a straightforward shoulder-to-shoulder collision in mid-air that left Van Wolfswinkel spiralling out of control and coming down very heavily on that right shoulder, as you said. Very similar to the one that Jamie Carragher suffered a short while ago that has kept him out, or will keep him out, for over 3 months. So this might be a costly injury for Utrecht, not just in terms of tonight's action, of course, but in terms of their own domestic season.
Well, he's been in sparkling form, hasn't he, this season?
19 goals, 11 in 11 in Eredivisie.
Yeah, he's definitely in a lot of pain, really struggling. If he's getting that sort of medical attention out on the pitch, and that's quite a serious injury.
Well, the sporting applause that you'd expect from the Liverpool fans. Ricky van Wolfswinkel out to the sidelines. The last we'll see of him tonight, they're very near certainty. We're not in a hurry to make a change just yet. We're not seeing an imminent arrival of a substitute. Less than a minute of the 45 to play. It might be one they're holding on till until half time, when they can have a good consideration about what they do. Here's Kelly. Jovanovic didn't quite
fall for him to have a crack on goal, but Aurelio here can sweep it over. It's a decent ball in as well. Silva Bao, the skipper, was back to head it away. Hammered back in. Babel. He was offside, was he? Yes, he was. The flag was up on this near side. So here's the man who is going to come on, Leon de Kogel, another youngster, 19 years of age. And my Dutch friend, I don't know if he was pulling my leg or not, but de Kogel translates as the bullet, quite literally, in the Dutch language. So here he comes, 19 years of age, the bullet. Minutes of additional time to be added at the end of this first period.
There'll be a minimum of 3 minutes added time. 3 minutes.
Yeah, let's hope that's not too bad for Van Wolfwinkel. You know, just coming around to the tunnel now, but unfortunately that does look a serious blow, and he looks like he'll be out of the game for some considerable time, so let's wish him well. But yeah, Liverpool in this first half, you know, the Jovanovic was the clear chance for me. Did well to get it out of his feet, got a very powerful shot. I think the keeper got just the slightest fingertips to it, but otherwise, you know, disappointing with the movement really from Liverpool.
Well, this is looking good, isn't it? Decent movement here. Shelby puts it in, not far away from the head of Nathan Eccleston.
Just again, you'll see, you know, that back post, you know, somebody coming in right at the back post. It's a good delivery, whipped in with pace, you know, going to cause the keeper, he can't come and collect it. You know, just a couple of times in this first half, just notice that you need those wide players coming in on the back post.
Kelly. It's Marble. He's done well. Duplan. Here's Cornelissa. We're hearing the news from down below, by the way, that Van Wolfswinkel has a suspected broken collarbone. He's already having morphine to try and ease the pain. Headed by Silva Bao, but to nobody in particular, so across comes Skrtel. An easy job of steering it back to his goalkeeper, Brad Jones. Here's Cole. Just a matter of seconds left in this opening half here. Can Liverpool finish? The real sparkle, not quite. The groans from the cop and all around as Cole fails to find the ball through, but there might be another opportunity here. The Icelandic referee has had a whistle in his mouth, it would seem, for quite a long time. And the challenge signals the end of the opening 45 minutes. Disappointing in terms of entertainment. The one real effort on goal, Milan Jovanovic rattling the crossbar with a thunderbolt of an effort midway through that first half, but otherwise chances have been thin on the ground. It remains Liverpool 0, Utrecht 0. We're back with the thoughts of our studio guests in just a few moments' time.
No goals then at Anfield and a very tepid first half. We've seen, Stan, lots of young men getting a chance to impress here tonight. None of them have taken it so far.
Well, before the game, Roy Hodgson will be looking at his players thinking, how many are going to be in contention to play against Fulham here on Saturday evening? The answer after half-time is none, to be perfectly honest. It's been slow, it's been predictable, it's been pedestrian. There have been one or two little glimpses, Nathan Eccleston a couple of runs, Ryan Babel, John Joe Shelvey. But this Joe Cole situation is really perplexing. He's not a left-sided midfielder. He's not a right-sided midfielder. He's a number 10. He plays in between their midfield and their back four. He picks the ball up and he creates. Completely wasted.
You've made it very clear you think Joe Cole is lost on the left. Let's go to Pat Nevin for his view on things down in the truck there, Pat.
Well, I've spent a bit of time in the wings and sometimes it gets a bit infuriating when you don't get enough of the ball. Joe Cole, as just as Stan says, is having a bit of a nightmare time out there, and I don't know if it's his fault. He gets the ball here, look, we follow him now, he's getting himself in a good position, in a good space, get the ball, okay then, that's fine. He's on the ball now, turn and then go forward, that's what you expect him to do. Because you want to get into those areas where you can hurt the defence, but no, Joe goes backwards. He's actually playing less like a left winger and more like a left back. He gets the ball there, but he doesn't go forward, he stands and waits on the line. By the time the ball's played miles forward, he's miles away from it, he's never going to get there, and I think that's what he's been asked to do. He's in the picture here in the left wing position, but he knows he's been told, defend, help your left fullback. So there he is. He's behind his left back there. And then he goes and makes a block. That's why Joe Cole's having a problem just now, because he's spending his entire time at left back. Sometimes he forgets and he plays his old way, the way he wants to play, positively. He goes and closes down a player. Fine, that's absolutely great. I'm now going close down the fullback now. Now let's hope my mates are behind me, help me. No, they're not. You're on your own, mate. So he's kind of a bit sickened by it all. He goes wide here. Now, that's a good position he's taken up for a left winger there. Try and get on the ball. Think forward. He is your creative player. Get him forward. Okay, the play goes away. It goes forward. They're going into the box. You want your creative player on the edge of the box helping you. But it breaks down. It breaks out. Where's our creative player, Joe Cole? He's a left back. He's away up there. I don't know. I'm not absolutely convinced that's Joe Cole's fault. I think he's worked hard. I think he looks very disappointed. He's absolutely gutted by it because he's having to play in a 4-4-2 as a guy standing in front of a left fullback. As a winger, I've had to do it before. It's sickening. You often get blamed for it. I'm not sure it's Joe's fault this time. I think he might be being told to do this.
I think he must have been told to do that. Well done indeed, Pat. Let's have a look at the one moment that might have got fans off their seat. A very good run and a decent effort from Jovanovic. You've got a goal in Bucharest.
Yeah, Jovanovic is playing on the right, so he's always looking to cut in, and that's been the one bright spark of the half, really.
I think the keeper might have just got a touch on that, you know?
He does, just as he comes in there. Slightest of touches onto the crossbar, but that was the real sort of bright spark. Milan Jovanovic, since he's come to Liverpool, has been desperately disappointing. But that was one bright spark there. But again, you ask the question, any Liverpool fan out there, who has played themselves into contention for a starting place against Fulham? And the answer is nobody at the moment. And that's got to be worrying for Liverpool.
Hey, deep sense of frustration then up here. You watching, I'm sure. And that man, Roy Hodgson. Unacceptable has been a word bandied around Anfield in recent days. The fans here, you watching on Five, expect more. We will look for a big improvement in the second half. No goals here at Anfield. We're hearing that Ricky van Volswinkel, sadly the top scorer for Utrecht, has got a broken collarbone. He is on his way to hospital, and that Kyriakos will be coming on for the Liverpool skipper, Skrtel. Let's go down and talk to an absolute Liverpool legend, shall we? Ian Rush, and he is with Tony Jones.
Ian, it hasn't been a brilliant first half, but your impressions of the Liverpool performance and also young Eccleston making his debut?
Yeah, it hasn't been a great performance. I think at the end of the day we need to push maybe 20 or 30 yards up the pitch and put the pressure on their defence. But Eccleston, yeah, he's quick. He's got past the defender a few times, and I think he's just looking for experience, and I think that comes with the confidence. Hopefully what they're looking at to maybe get a shot or two at goal, and I think just he's trying to get a bit of confidence.
That's Liverpool taken care of. What about Wales now, with Gary Speed being appointed this week as the new manager? A good appointment?
Yeah, I hope so. I think at the end of the day, you know, that everyone's looking for a Welshman, and Gary, he's been a great professional, and I think we all wish him the best of luck and all that, and hopefully, you know, he can bring Wales into a new era. That's what's needed and all that, and Gary, he's a lovely lad, and we're all hoping that he does the best for Wales.
Opening a new restaurant here at Anfield tonight called The Boot Room. Great to see Ian Rush. You have another chance to win in our competition now. A pair of VIP tickets to see the Premier League team of your choice in action. The football shirt of your choice, a 42-inch LCD TV plus an Apple iPad. All you've got to do is text football to 6550 or post your name and phone number to Europa 6, PO Box 46556, London N10WW. Those tests cost £1 plus one message at standard network rate. Lines close midday tomorrow, and 3 days later for postal entries, we'll contact the winner and we'll announce their name on 5.tv. There we are, confirmation of the change, and Kyriakos is coming on, and he is going to be the new skipper as well. We all hope for a massive improvement in the second half. Let's rejoin our commentary team, shall we? Former Red centre-half John Scales and Dave Woods.
It can only get better. It can only get better. I tell you what, there were times in that first half when the Wolfsfinkel morphine, we would fancy a bit of that up here. It wasn't great, but it will get better. Sotirios Kyriakos confirmed that he's on in the second half. Martin Skrtel, the man who was the captain, has given away. He's also handed over the captain's armband to Kyriakos as well. Otherwise, it's as you were for this Liverpool lineup. If you are joining us late as this second half gets underway, a reminder that it is very much a youthful look to this Liverpool team tonight. Danny Wilson, the 18-year-old at centre-half, Jonjo Shelvey, the 18-year-old in midfield, and Nathan Eccleston at 19 years of age, making his first start for Liverpool tonight. But it's Utrecht here who are starting the more adventurous. They've made one change, of course. Leon de Kugel has come on. Wolfsfinkel is the man who's gone off injured, as we heard. And it will be a Liverpool throw on that far side. Any news, by the way, that Avram Grant's future at West Ham is very much in doubt at this stage. The news we're hearing is that he has been told he has to win one of the next three games to keep his job. Start with Blackburn away, who of course rather famously have dispensed with their manager this week. It's a Premier League that's going mad, John.
It seems to be the season, you know, December, coming up to Christmas. It sort of lasted a long time. Everybody had said it was many of the managers had survived, you know, for longer than previous seasons maybe, but suddenly it seems to have gone crazy. I don't know. You know, I was trying to think on the drive up here this afternoon how many sort of managers are safe. And I can sort of only think of sort of four or five really that you'd think are in strong positions. Other than that, it seems to be that so many of the managers now, with the Premier League as it is and the positions in the table, are in increasing pressure. It's no surprise that Avram Grant is under pressure. The results have been so poor and they're, you know, adrift at the bottom of the table.
Well, Utrecht looking bright here. Nieholt giving the only ball for de Kogel, but ricocheting through to Brad Jones in that Liverpool goal. Reminder that he's making only his second appearance for Liverpool tonight, Brad Jones, the Australian. Here's Wilson. And back corner, Lisa. Silva Bauer. Bit of a controversial figure with Utrecht at the moment is Michael Silva Bauer. He wants to leave, he's expected to leave in January. And he has his eye on playing in the English Premier League. Meantime, here's a man who's much closer to that position, Nathan Eccleston. Ryan Babel. Easily away in the end. Keller. Ryan Babel, the Dutchman, is getting a bit of attention from those Utrecht fans now. He's playing quite close to them at the Anfield Road end of this ground.
Yeah, I think we heard at half time there, you know, we heard from Ian Rush saying they should be pushing up the field another 20-30 yards. We saw at times in that first half very poor, you know, how deep Liverpool played and how little support they got when they closed down up front. And when you've got huge gaps like that, it's very difficult to regain possession, then spark any movement and, you know, get into that final third and get bodies into the box. So absolutely spot on there. Again, with Pat Nevin's analysis with Joe Cole, we saw that he really was a peripheral figure in the first half at times. The glimpses we got when he drifted inside and played in midfield, just behind the strikers, that's when Liverpool's best passages of play were relevant. And again, you know, he's got to be brought into the game in a much better way than that first half.
Here's Mertens towards Maguire, who is taking a tumble under the challenge from Jovanovic. No foul. Cole has a little look up and sees that Fabio Aurelio has arrived inside the Utrecht half. It's Babel. And to tell every time he has the ball in this half, with the reaction from those Dutch supporters, Duplan brings it away, and here's Nieholt.
This is Mertens. Nesso's gone on the overlapping run. Mertens rather fancies a dick himself and a bit of a palm stinger for Brad Jones. Soft hands. Safe take.
Yeah, it was the sub just bearing down on Brad Jones. If he had a fumble, that Leander Kugel, who came on for Van Wolfswinkel. So he had to be good there with his feet, with his hands, just to make sure he gathered that. Wasn't too powerful a shot, didn't cause him any problems in the end.
This is Cole. Marble again. Andries Mertens. Here's a statistic to lift your spirits, by the way. Liverpool have scored 8 goals in this competition so far this season. 5 of those have come in the last 15 minutes. So we've got something to look forward
to. So hang in there, hang in there.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we just saw Joe Cole cut inside and play a little 1-2 with Ryan Babel. Babel's touch, you know, again, runs away, lose possession. And Utrecht back on the attack, you know, and it's very frustrating when you see, you know, players, teams, Liverpool getting into positions here and not making the most of it. It's just that lack of quality that is so missing here today.
Here's Mertens. Mertens. Nesu, the left back, joining in the attack here. Solid challenge from Martin Kelly, but it's a corner kick for the Dutch side. Pressure on Liverpool here, 6 minutes into this second half. Here's Maguire to take this corner. Liverpool having to be careful here. It's a decent one in. Tumbling header by Sander Keller, I think it was. Liverpool survive.
It was Martin Kelly went with the run with him, but I thought he was going to have a get a header on target, but I think Kelly did enough to put him off there.
Just a heavy touch from Kelly, and he again just did enough to recover that situation. Here comes Eccleston. Last off the young Liverpool player.
Decision, to be honest. I mean, the tackle's come in and he's taken Eccleston with him, taken the ball with him. Yeah. Did it touch it? Very doubtful for me.
This is Mihai Nesu, the Romanian international. Cole. Muscled off it by Barry Maguire, and a chance here. Leon de Coco got the shooting position. He claimed he was being hampered unfairly there.
Well, Wilson was prepared to give the foul away here. Realised that he got caught underneath the ball. Did well to put the pressure on the forward. Put him under, you know, enough pressure to put him off on the shot. And quite willing to give away the foul. Absolutely right. But good defending there when he got himself in some difficulty.
Jones to clear away. Eccleston. Feather of a touch to that. So Silver Bauer. Running away from challenges, but not quickly enough. Paulson caught him from behind. Well, we've got snow forecast tonight, and there's a young man who's been wrapped up for the weather. The eyes have it. Just as though he might have been falling asleep there. You could hardly blame him. De Kogel, chased hard by Nesu, kept in play as well. So problems here potentially for Liverpool had it been a better ball.
Yeah, not with quality like that. We've seen it a couple of times in the first half from Utrecht, getting themselves into advanced positions and some really wasteful play, poor distribution, and sort of summed up the game in many ways. You know, just it's crying out for somebody with some real quality. So there you go, that's the hat I need to, up here in the... Well, I don't think you'd have it on television, but trying to keep warm, aren't we?
It's not as cold as I thought
it's
it might
not,
be,
no,
actually.
There's a few
fair.
Softies around Anfield tonight. Yeah. It's not that chilly, actually, is it? It's chilly, but not freezing.
But, you know, just looking for the senior players, you know, that to have that quality. I'm disappointed with Paulson in midfield. He really hasn't had any authority in there to get a grip of the game. You look around, apart from that, you know, it's a lot of youngsters. Joe Cole's tried to drift into the game when he can and influence it, but, you know, very difficult from a wide position. Paulson, I think, has got to take much more control and dictate the pace of the play. Now, whether he's capable of doing that, I'm not so sure.
Pacheco might be arriving on the scene very soon. Here's Babel, who might well be a man he replaces. Ivanovic ahead of him, Babel taking it on himself. The Dutchman failing to impress in front of those Dutch supporters at that end.
Yeah, I think he looked a bit confused with Ivanovic's run. Ivanovic ran across instead of sort of pulling wide maybe to drag the defender. Just for a moment it looked like both would go with Ivanovic, but they gave him the space to just knock it out wide and get shot away on his right foot. But, you know, Eccleston I think has done very well tonight. You know, I thought he's looked lively, he's put himself about. He's worked the channels very, very hard. You know, looks a bright prospect without ever seeing any real sort of quality in front of goal from him this evening.
Well, one bright spark off and one bright spark on. Young Daniel Pacheco, the Spaniard, the youth international, Spanish youth international. Very much a favourite of those Anfield watchers as Babel takes it on here. Cole's in the middle. Ivanovic was there too. Pacheco right at the back, but can't get it across.
Well, I think it was Pacheco's ball, wasn't it? Very incisive, very good through ball. Babel making that run as he has with Eccleston in that first sort of hour of the game. Got himself in a position again, the final ball really disappointing.
This is Jan Wouters. Keller. Duplan. Silver Bauer. Duplan. That was disappointing from his point of view.
So is that.
Cole. Ivanovic. Side and has picked him up. The right back has made good progress here and driven across towards Ryan Babel, who just needed a touch.
Well, for me, that's the best passage of play of the game, really, apart from Ivanovic's chance of the first half. They've worked the ball very, very well. Martin Kelly's broken forward down the right-hand side. We said they've got to be another 20, 30 yards up the pitch. When you get a full-back in that position, he's able to break into the box, drives a quality ball across that's been lacking again, you know, and it's made to look easy when you just get in those little advanced positions, get the ball, turn, run into space, and you've got players moving, and that's what we've seen a distinct lack of here this evening.
Taken on by Dekogel. Kyriakos trying to get in the way of things. Mihai Nessun. Michel Vaughan. Five international caps to his name already for the Dutch team. He was on the bench throughout the World Cup. Sorry, John.
No, it's just very difficult to know what to make when you see these sort of games. You know, when it is effectively the dead rubber, as we know, they've already qualified.
Looked like a handball by Ivanovic there.
Did for
it?
A second, didn't it?
Allowing it to play on, and here comes Fabio Aurelio. Neatly done, driven in. Juan Lisa blocks it away.
again, more encouraging play from Liverpool, you know, just having Joe Cole there again in a central midfield advanced role, being able to play Patrick Ho just gets the challenge in there again, you know, looks like he's injected a bit of energy and pace about this team.
Well, they really love him, Daniel Pacheco. He's just had a new deal, a new contract. He might be going out on loan in January to get a bit more first-team experience, but he's a real live wire. Meantime, Liverpool having to defend here, having to be careful because the opportunity is knocking for Utrecht. The door remains firmly closed.
Saying, you know, as a game that they've already won the group, qualified. There we go, just another chance.
And crashed in! Leon de Kergel, bullet by name. Well, it's an extra on that occasion. There's Pacheco.
You know, it's a chance for players to play their way into the manager's thoughts. You know, you've got to put the effort in. Is that a handball from Babel?
Yeah, you've got to do.
But, you know, a chance to impress the manager. Look, you know, have that energy about them, have the passion, but have the quality as well. Certainly the atmosphere's risen a bit. You've got to hand that to Pacheco, who's come on and injected that energy about it, as I just said. Crowd a little bit larger, although most of it's coming probably from the Utrecht end, isn't it? They're jumping up and down, more probably to keep warm than in excitement of their team. I think they've been pretty poor, Utrecht. Final ball has been woeful and pretty inadequate, to be honest, to cause Liverpool too many problems. But you get the chance there where Brad Jones had to be alert to the shot.
Cole on the stretch, Paulson. Up to Pacheco. Early ball, good ball. This is Fabio Aurelio. Looking to tease them. Has support from Pacheco, who might be going from distance, and does. Plenty of time for Michel Vorm to readjust his body and drop on that safely. Game stretching a little here. Chance at one end, and there's an opportunity at the other. Looked in towards Barry Maguire.
Yeah, the game is getting stretched, and you know, there again we saw Aurelio getting forward. It's the advantage of getting your fullbacks to really push on. Pacheco was in narrow, Cole was in narrow, and it gives your fullbacks plenty of license to get forward. And certainly in a game like this, there's no reason why they shouldn't.
This is Shelby. Here's Pacheco. Cole. Off he goes. Joe Cole. Marble caught on his heels as they try to chase that one. Dupin. Lisa. Silverbauer. There's Vautens. Kugel, Lee Holt, beaten to it.
Oh, he should have taken it on, shouldn't he? One pass too many.
Silverbauer. Duplan. Here's Mertens. Maguire looking for the return.
Some noise, aren't they?
Terrific, I'm glad they're here.
Yeah.
The Utrecht supporters. They had not stopped. They were in here at 6:30 tonight.
good hour and a half before the match began. That's the Dutch version of Yellow Submarine. If anybody knows the words to the Dutch version of Yellow Submarine, it would be an interesting text. And they have a free kick here, which the Dutchman Barry Maguire is going to try and whip in. And we got it over the head of the first defender, Shelvey. Kogel unable to do much with it.
It was Danny Wilson there again. Just had his two hands close to his body. Just worried for a moment that he was maybe going to catch the ball almost, but did well to track the runner. They defended it well.
Looking to respond here, so there's the feel at the moment of a really good cup tie in terms of atmosphere. Anfield is rocking just for the moment. It's the fans who are providing all the entertainment. Here's Wouters. Mertens. Nessa has gone sprinting up on that left hand side, the left back here. There are a couple to aim for in the middle, but he can't get it beyond Martin Kelly.
Yeah, shocking from Jovanovic. You know, when you look at that, Kelly's got the player to mark. Dutch player makes a break down the left hand side, and Jovanovic has just allowed him to run into a dangerous area. And you know, that's just basics of the game. That I'm amazed by that.
Here comes Maguire. Jones connected with something, I'm not sure what. And all the way goes to Michel Vaux in the Utrecht goal. 8,500 under-17s here tonight. I wonder how many of them answered that famous question. Come on, go on, Doc.
I thought Jan Boutens, the centre-half, was going to score there. I thought he almost had a free header at that that corner. Here he is on the ball.
Well, Dirk Kuyt is going to get his wish, it looks like. He's going to come on in just a few moments' time. Utrecht still looking to attack here. Poulsen with a challenge. Here's Pacheco.
Back to Poulsen, Pacheco.
Niholt. Well won by Aurelio, here's Babel. Jovanovic. Here's Shelvey. Now Kelly. Babel making the run in the middle, but the ball was too high.
Of course, that's the trouble when you get the fullbacks in those areas and they put in the cross. There's only really Babel who's in there. Joe Cole's never really going to break his neck to get into the near post or get to the back post. But yeah, another good, well-worked passage of play to get into a good crossing area. But you've got to have the bodies in there. You've got to have the shape of the team that's set up to take advantage of that. They certainly look better with Jovanovic pushed on more on that right-hand side, and Pacheco, you know, pushed on the left-hand side. That seems to have dragged the team forward. Joe Cole just playing off Babel.
Here's Cole. Shelvey. Cool.
Kyriakos. Second half substitute, Sotirios Kyriakos, having come from Skirtle. Taking over the captain's armband in a Liverpool team that lacks a great deal of experience. It's mostly done by Cornelissa. And here's Kyriakos again. Kelly again off Jovanovic, Cole, Pavel, Pacheco, all options. It is Pacheco that it's played to, but it was a poor ball. He slipped as he turned, and momentum is lost. Oh dear. Well, that sums it up really, doesn't it?
I saw a similar face on Saturday against Newcastle. Yeah, very frustrating for a manager when you get into good positions. You know, he's expecting a lot from the youngsters, and rightly so. You know, they come here, they've got an opportunity, they've got to perform, and not enough of them are this evening. But you know, it'll be good for Joe Cole to get, you know, minutes under his belt again, out there coming back to fitness and form. Absolutely important for Liverpool that he does. You know, and they've got the likes of Dirk Kuyt on the bench, Torres on the bench, Reina, Carragher to come back, Gerrard out at the moment as well. You know, when you look at all that, and Daniel Agger, you know, you look at the number of players, that's 6, 7, 8, you know, top-class players, when they're missing, it does make it very difficult.
Here comes Cole for Liverpool. Babel. Unpicked by Niholt. And a chance here for the man we've just seen come on, Thomas Orr, the Australian international, who's replaced Edouard Duplan. To show some of his trickery with a high and searching ball. Does it find the target? So there's the new man, 19 years of age, Thomas Orr. One of three Australians that Utrecht signed from Brisbane Roar last April. And if you're not playing, you might as well have a couple of sweets. They're just pretending they're not eating them, aren't they? Sneak it in there. Closer and closer.
I think the crowd, the Utrecht crowd, sense that, and they've just been warming up second half, haven't they? Ready for him.
It's going to be Jovanovic, I think, who's going to be replaced by Dirk Kuyt. There's Boutens. Connected here by Orr. Knocked away by Kelly. Listen to this reaction. It's not just the Liverpool fans are applauding here, but the Utrecht supporters too, showing their approval of the man who's about to come onto the pitch, Dirk Kuyt. Milan Jovanovic is the man who gives way, but Dirk Kuyt, the Dutch international, but more than that, 5 years at Utrecht in the late 90s, early 2000s, 67 goals in 183 games, made him a real favourite amongst those Utrecht supporters, and it would appear he remains very much a favourite.
Well, he always gives 100%, doesn't he? He works so hard for the team. You know what you get with Dirk Kuyt. You get the quality as well as the work ethic. And, you know, for me, one of Liverpool's most important players.
Here he comes, chasing a lost cause, though. And he has got a corner here. What price a Kuyt goal, by the way, in the final minutes of this game. We're very nearly into Liverpool's happiest hunting period. Just over 16 minutes of the game remaining. This has been when they have been most potent from here on in.
Yeah, and I think we've seen signs of it coming.
Well by Valkens. Remains remains goalless in the game between Napoli and Steaua Bucharest. So just to underline the fact that if it stays that way, it will be the Bucharest team that will be following Liverpool into the knockout stages. The draw for the knockout stages taking place tomorrow, or rather Friday. Some tricky potential trips for Liverpool and Manchester City, of course. Don't forget they've already qualified for the latter stages of this competition. They'll be making the draw not just for the last 32, but also the last 16 on Friday. So a clearer path on the road to Dublin for the two English clubs and, of course, the Scottish club Rangers, who've come into this competition via the Champions League route. Last year's winners Atletico Madrid are struggling to make it to the last 32. In action tomorrow, needing to win. Aris favourites to go through in that group along with Bayer Leverkusen. Here Liverpool searching for something, but over the head of Bartle. Joe Cole's not had the happiest of nights tonight, but it is a family time. There's his wife, Caroline, and baby Ruby, Carly, his wife.
That's the outfit you need on a night like this.
Which one, wife or baby?
And Torres, of course, what a week last Monday. The Villa game he missed. And they were so convincing here against Villa. Great win. Recent dad.
Yeah. Roy Hodgson's been talking about the weight off his shoulders. He said it was a long time since his son was born. He just about remembers how difficult it is, or the worries that you have as a potential new father when the baby's born safe and well and everybody's happy. Suddenly the weight lifts and a new smile comes on your face. Here's Kelly. Still going. And did well to get it over. Michael Ball with a safe catch. Nesu. Out by Aurelio. Headed by Kelly. Here's Nesu. Or lifting it in. Can he help us with a header? Mertens. It's always going to be difficult to hit one on target.
I think Kelly's hurt his calf, whether he's pulled it or he's just got a bit of cramp. I'm not quite sure over there at right back. Looked like he fell a little bit awkwardly, but should be able to run it off. But good technique there in the strike.
So 13 minutes just under left to play here. Liverpool through as group winners, of course, but looking to finish this stage of the competition with real sparkle. Utrecht who are offering the threat here, Thomas Orr. Okay, it was a decent ball in, and Fabio Aurelio having to concede the corner. And Utrecht are still playing with a little bit of purpose at times, aren't they?
Yeah, and they've got the rewards there for a corner. Great ball, great delivery, but they've got players breaking into the box, and there we've seen it, you know, in this second half. Liverpool have worked some good positions, got themselves down the right and left-hand sides, but they've only got Babel as the lone striker to show for it, and he's been missed on many occasions.
So here comes Nyholt lifting it in. Very important touch at the near edge of this 6-yard penalty area. She's brushing the head of Fabio Aurelio, and important that it did there for Liverpool. So dropping it down. De Kogel looking to work a way through for Barry Maguire. Back to Thomas Orr. Here's Pacheco.
this competition is certainly going to hot up in the knockout rounds. You know, we talk about the draw for the last 32 and 16 on Friday. I think this Europa League will come to life in the knockout stages, as I say. It's been relatively straightforward for Liverpool to qualify. We haven't really seen them extended that much. You know, in a relatively poor group, Utrecht I haven't been particularly impressed with. Napoli I expected more from. Steaua at times have looked dangerous, but again, Liverpool have been comfortable in this group. But it belies, you know, their league form in the Premier League is, you know, has been so stuttering, their away form so poor, that that's really the biggest issue for Liverpool this season is getting through this comfortably. But it's really getting back on form in the league. And as I say, you know, three home games out of four to come. This is really a crucial period of time for them, the Christmas period.
Here's Wilson. Well, he's got a busy period ahead of him, hasn't he? So, an early departure. Come and watch the game, get the hard work done afterwards.
He should be getting ready for Christmas, not sat here watching football.
Here's Thomas Orr. Fabio Aurelio, and now Pacheco. Cole. Liverpool looking for a flourish here. Babel, Pacheco. Count is wide right and unmarked, but Pacheco was harried enough by Cornelissa. Unable to release that pass.
When you're playing these sort of games, so many new faces, it is very difficult to get any cohesion between the team. It's very much, you know, the players that come in, they're really focused on their own job, wanting to impress. So it's very much an individual performance that they want to show to Roy Hodgson. They can really play well or offer something that he hasn't maybe seen before. And that goes against the ethic of the team then, really functioning as a unit. And that's what we really haven't seen today.
There's Cole, rather running into a cul-de-sac, but finding a way out. Now Pacheco. Let it roll. Cat. There's an opportunity to write his name large across this cup tie tonight, but unable to get the shot away. It's still with Aurelio, though. That's a decent ball in. Blocked away by Joe Cole's shot. Well, what an opportunity that was.
Well, it was a phenomenal cross, wasn't it? Great cross. Put them all sorts of trouble at the back. Blocked on the line, and it fell for him just to, you thought he'd slot that one away. Another fine block again.
You almost got a sense that Ryan Babel didn't really believe that that ball was going to be as good as it was. And left it for Cole. Here is Cole. Aurelio. This is Maguire. Thomas Orr. Pass beyond Kelly, but Kelly kept track with him. So another change here. Adam Soroto is coming on here. And Dutch Irishman Barry Maguire is the man to give way. So Soroto, another of the Australians, hoping that he can provide a real influence, a winning influence maybe, on what is remaining in this game. 6.5 minutes still to play. Silva Bala. Nessu.
looking for a bit of endeavour here. Now Pacheco. This is Paulson. Here's Kelly. Back for Count. Shelby. Well, they're keeping possession comfortably enough here, Liverpool, but not really hurting their opponents thus far. Babel. He's working hard to win it back, and he has won it back. Shelby. Kyriakos. Is he going to have a dent from a long way out? He's certainly having a look at it, isn't he? But he puts it straight at the calves of Michael Silverbauer, and it disappears up for a Liverpool throw.
Yeah, 85 minutes gone. Time flies when you're having fun, doesn't it? It's yeah, frustrating performance from Liverpool, but you know, a lot of youngsters out there. Very difficult circumstances to give a great performance. Great crowd in here. You know, they did the incentive for youngsters to come in for free. They were with an adult, so credit to Liverpool for that. They haven't had too much to shout about. Been a sort of typical Liverpool performance. You know, should have been on the front foot more. Should have taken more risks. Should have had more movement, more pace and energy about them. And just to, you know, again there, you know, just that touch when the ball's been played into. Touch forever has not been good enough. Final pass never assured enough.
Here comes Mertens with a ball in. Kyriakos with a header away. Pacheco busying himself but can't keep possession. On the plus side from Liverpool's point of view, only a fourth consecutive game they've kept a clean sheet at home. If it stays this way, only two goals conceded in the last six matches at Anfield now.
Sterner tests than this one to come, aren't there?
Cat. Thomas Orr. Shelby. Silva. It's not been the happiest of night tonight for Roy Hodgson. And there the man next to him, Sammy Lee, is second in command, which rather smoothly leads us on to our movie tonight. Second in command, only four words needed: Jean-Claude Van Damme. It's a cracker, action-packed drama. He takes on an entire country's army. Chance here. Joe Cole has manufactured it, forcing the foul from the defender.
Well, they've had a habit of scoring late. You mentioned it earlier. Is this the moment they
I don't think there are any doubts as to who's going to take this. Joe Cole, having won the free kick, is the man who's
collected the ball, brought the ball back, made sure the ball's in the right position on the turf.
I think Daniel Pacheco's got the message. He walks away. A little discussion here going on between Fabio Aurelio and Jonjo Shelby.
Aurelio had his chance in the first half. He'll not be looking again.
Cole is sizing it up. Here comes Cole, but he hits it at the first man there, Thomas Orr. Aurelio. Deflection. Cole! Just needed a faint touch.
Yeah, it's a very difficult chance. Very difficult, you know, coming across his body at that angle. Very difficult to get a shot way on target. But those are the signs that you've got to see a player getting back into form, getting up to the pace of the game. You know, he's had a disappointing Anfield career so far. It's been hampered by suspensions and injuries. He's desperate, absolutely desperate to prove his worth here at Anfield. It's not for want of trying. He's got the quality, but you've also got to be playing in a good team, good players around you. You've got to bring each other into the game, bring the life back to Liverpool, and that's going to take a collective effort from every single one of the players that is out there, you know, over the next 3-4 weeks over Christmas. As I say, they've got winnable games, but it's got to be the likes of Torres. Been very disappointing. He's got to offer a lot more. You know, and so have the rest of the players. You know, Morelos is back in there. Gerrard will be back from injury, maybe against Fulham at the weekend. That'll be just what Roy Hodgson needs. To see Gerrard out there against Fulham will give them the perfect lift. You know, with these injuries sort of improving, hopefully an increase in form. And certainly 3 out of 4 games at home, winnable, as is Blackpool away, you'd suggest.
Well, we saw Roy Hodgson looking quite disappointed there, didn't we? He's aware even before the match began that his side had already qualified, so there was no real pressure on his team tonight. But I guess the disappointment is from the fact that if this is the second string, if this is the depth that they have at Liverpool, then they haven't really sparked tonight, have they? They haven't given much reassurance.
No, they haven't sparked. As I said, you know, a couple of times, it's very, very difficult when you get a lot of new faces in a team to come out here and put on a performance. You know, individually they'll be looking to do something themselves. Collectively, very difficult to play as a unit and impress. It has been a disappointing performance, and it does show the lack of the quality of depth that Liverpool have. And you know, this rebuilding process goes on. There's been a lot of focus on the youngsters that they brought into the club. Wilson, Jonjo Shelvey's done well in midfield there. You know, the youngsters have done okay. But, you know, the likes of Paulson hasn't shown enough class or ambition within this game this evening to show that he's got a long-term future. Very disappointing display. Joe Cole's got to get himself back into form. You know, so it's those players on the bench, in the treatment room, they've got to come back in again and really turn Liverpool's season around.
Marble. And here's Thomas Hall, the Australian. 90 seconds left to play. And the drama in the other game, by the way, we've just heard that Napoli have scored in injury time against Steaua Bucharest, which means that suddenly they are the team that are going through along with Liverpool. Liverpool topping the group, Napoli going through in second place. Unless something even more dramatic happens. Pacheco knocking it away, one back by Mertens. Mertens has done ever so well here, looking for support but finding only Liverpool limbs in there, and it's desperately cleared away.
Yeah, he's been their most impressive player by far, hasn't he, Mertens? I thought, you know, he's done a great job out there. He's looked lively, clever little player, inventive, made the right choices at the right times. Been very impressed with him. But you know, the Europa League is definitely the area where Liverpool have got to be looking to win some silverware this year. The FA Cup, obviously, they got Man United, you know, in the round just in January, knocked out by Northampton in the Carling Cup. Way off the pace in the Premier League. So the Europa League for Roy Hodgson, obviously, with getting Fulham, you know, so far last year, looks like, you know, their best bet for silverware, and it would be important that they give him good performances.
Well, another shot away, but always comfortable enough for Brad Jones. So here we go, we're over the 3 minutes now, and Liverpool will take it no further than that. Well, Roy Hodgson's side have negotiated their way safely through the foothills of this league stage of this Europa League, and now the steep climb begins in February with a knockout. Not a hero's night tonight for Dirk Kuyt, but Liverpool have done enough before this night began. 0-0 on the evening, and we await the draw with some interest. And then the last 32, as all roads lead to Dublin.
Thank you, Dave. Dave Woods and John Scales, your commentators. That draw is in Switzerland on Friday. Job done then for Liverpool. Dirk Kuyt salutes those Dutch fans that love him so much. My feelings go actually to the crowd. The Dutch fans have been absolutely fantastic. 30,000 plus Liverpool supporters have been unbelievably patient and understanding as well. Post-match reaction from Stan Cronenmore, from Pat Nevin and from Liverpool when you rejoin us. close to 4,000 Dutch fans and the Utrecht team have had a great time on Merseyside, celebrating a goalless draw here at Anfield. Absolute credit to their club and to their country. Well done to those fans. Let's just check on how the table looks now. Well, Napoli will go through with Liverpool, the Uruguayan really good player, Edinson Cavani, with a winner in injury time to beat Steaua Bucharest and put them out of Europe. Let's have a word with Dirk Kuyt. He is with Tony Jones.
Dirk, I know you were determined to get a game tonight. Disappointed not to be on from the start?
No, it's up to the manager. We play a lot of important games this month, so he has to make his choices. And obviously, Saturday is not a very important game for us, so he decided to rest me.
But good to get on and to get such a fantastic reception as well from the Utrecht supporters.
Yeah, that's great. You know, the supporters from Utrecht were unbelievable, just as the Liverpool supporters. But, you know, after 7 years to play against them and to get, the crowd like this, it's unbelievable and, shows a lot of respect and very thankful for that.
I suppose the hard work was already done because you had qualified. And is the Europa League the most realistic possibility of silverware this season?
Yeah, we have a couple of targets, and obviously we like to win trophies, and I think we have a very good chance to win this trophy. So it's good to be top of the group, and we'll wait and see what our next opponent is.
Thanks very much for your time. Appreciate that.
Yeah. And go to the Five website to hear what Roy Hodgson has got to say about tonight's game. Not a great one, eh?
Well, I think that we have to put it in context that Liverpool had already qualified the group, but I mentioned in the first half how many players have put themselves forward for selection. For the Fulham game, you probably could say Fabio Aurelio in terms of his second half. Liverpool played a little bit narrower. Joe Cole played in a more advanced position centrally, and Fabio Aurelio put two or three decent crosses in. But like I say, I'd be worried with the players that played today. There aren't too many knocking on the door, okay. Are there? Let's be honest.
Down to Pat Nevin for his final thoughts on this one. Pat.
In the end, I think Liverpool have got through, and they've got through not using Torres, not using Gerrard. So that's actually not too bad. It wasn't hugely exciting, but minimum of fuss, very efficient. That summed up what Liverpool done tonight, and it summed up what Danny Wilson done tonight. For me, if anyone's put himself forward, that boy has. I thought he played well.
And a final thought from you, Stan. In they go to the draw on Friday, and I think deep down we're probably all hoping for Rangers, aren't we?
Yeah, I mean, a Battle of Britain would be great. I was up there to watch Manchester United a couple of weeks ago at Ibrox, and the atmosphere is fantastic. I think that both sets of players and both countries would be up for it. Like I say, try and avoid Eastern Europe, 6-7-8 hour flight in a busy February that's going to come up.
Cheers, Stan. Thank you very much indeed for your company, as always. Well, there we are. You be sure to stay with us right here on Channel 5 for Second in Command. That's coming right up. We're going to be back in February. Rangers then joining Manchester City and Liverpool. The Europa League becomes an absolute knockout. Happy Christmas from all of us on the Five football team. Good night from Anfield.